Yes, Pierre. bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you are also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of God.
It's good enough.
Jesus Christ.
Someone she knew for many, many years. And was
teaches them how to live with the humility, patience, gentleness, and bearing with one another through love. He encourages them to keep the unity of the Spirit to the bond of peace. In each family, these values will bring understanding, mercy, and forgiveness. We pray that the same understanding, respect, and mercy will be part of Jennifer and Brian's new life. Then John in the Gospel says clearly, when Jesus says, "Remain in my love. Love one another as I love." What kind of a love is Jesus talking about? What is love? All of us have a different answer for this question. But we have to see the love according to the message of Jesus Christ in the Bible. Jesus is the model of true love. He donated his life for his friends and exercised his ministry, healing the sick, preaching the good news, serving and instructing his apostles. Then he died on the cross. Love is to donate one's life so others may have a life. Love is service. Is to help other person to grow in understanding and also faith. Love is open, is to be open to the needs of others and help them as Jesus did. This is what this Eucharist celebration tells to Jennifer and Brian. Follow the example of Jesus. Nourish your souls with his body and blood. Listen to his word. Nourishing your mind with the word and love of Jesus, you will have a joy and new life, and will have a fulfilled life close to your family and your friends. Stay seated. I invite Jennifer and Brian to stand in front of the altar, and also I invite both the mothers to come forward and light the unity candle. Dear beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with his sacred seal. Christ blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by the Holy Baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of a married life. And so in the presence of the Church, I ask you to state your intentions. Jennifer and Brian, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly, Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of a holy matrimony, join your hands and declare your consent before God and His church. Brian, do you take Jennifer to be your wife? Do you promise to be faithful to her in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love her and to honor her all the days of your life? I do. Jennifer, do you take Brian to be your husband? Do you promise to be faithful to him in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love him and to honor him all the days of your life?
I do. Where to begin? Brian, you are so special to me. Our relationship is so sacred to me, I always thought to have more of a private approach to it. I feel as if I want to protect what is personal and close to me. At the same time, what a privilege it is to be surrounded here today by our people and proclaim our eternal promise to one another. Truly, what a blessing. Loving you comes easy, second nature. Writing vows, on the other hand, does not. How can I combine how much I adore you into a few minutes? How are words amount to convey how much you mean to me? This morning, while getting ready in the bridal suite, we had an early 2000s R&B playlist going, and I thought, can I just pull a lyric from every song and put it together? All great lines, no one will know. Can my own words come alive from a page and sum up how much I love you? I will sure try. I have been asked a few times before, how did I know mine was the one? How did I know this was it? What has been our favorite memories together? I usually pause and am at a loss for words. My favorite memories together aren't a grand romantic gesture or an exotic getaway to places we've been around the world. My favorite memories happen almost every day. When you wake up in the morning, you can check yourself out the mirror and ask me, Jen, are my muscles jacked? Thoughtful you are, like when we're on a weekend getaway, deserve good things that come my way, but you always assure me I'm deserving of everything and more without any hesitation, like it's a given. You are the most sweet, hardworking, passionate, expressive, grounded, disciplined, punctual, lovable person I know. Your existence and you just being you influenced me to emulate those qualities myself and want to work towards being a better person every day. You give me the effortless freedom to always be completely myself and not think twice about it. My glass is full, I am sure of it, but with the love you pour for us, it becomes constantly overflowing. With you by my side, I'm going to need a much, much bigger glass.
Definitely should have gone first. Jen, I love you. And through my words and my actions, I promise to remind you every single day for the rest of our lives how much I love you. As you know too well, I don't take anything very seriously. I hope that that'll keep me laughing. But this commitment to you as your husband, as hopefully one day as the father of your children, means more to me than you can ever know. Watching the way my dad loved my mom, the way my grandpa loved my grandma, and even though he can't be here today, through his actions and his words, has taught me what it takes to be your dutiful husband. I promise to do my best to provide for you and our family what they have given for me. My promise and commitment is to not only you, but to your mom and your dad as well, to be the man that they would entrust their daughter to be. I promise to always love you, care for you, make you laugh, make you feel secure and committed for the rest of our lives. Jennifer, I love you. I promise to remind you through all my words and actions every single day how much I love you. She should have gone first.
Receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
And I'm here with him.
Thank you.
of life.
One more.
Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever living and caring God, we have expressed our prayers confidently that you will now look upon our many needs, consider our trust in faith, and in your great love, grant the needs requests which we present to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the honor. May the power of your Holy
when your days and your nights get a little bit cold.